Eat these 10 foods to save your pancreas from damage. The pancreas is an important organ in the body that aids in digestion and blood sugar management. It generates enzymes that aid in the digestion of food in the small intestine and hormones like insulin and glucagon that regulate blood sugar levels. A healthy pancreas is critical for general health and well-being. While genetics and lifestyle choices can have an impact on pancreatic health, food is also crucial. Today, we'll go through some of the best pancreatic foods. These types of foods can help promote pancreatic function and lower the chance of acquiring conditions such as pancreatitis or pancreatic cancer. Now, let's get started. Number 1. Garlic. The herb you love might also help protect your pancreas. Allicin, one of the many antibacterial and antioxidant compounds found in garlic, can help fight off harmful bacteria and viruses. Garlic's anti-inflammatory and antioxidant properties can also aid in reducing pancreatic toxicity. If you consume too much alcohol, it can wreak havoc on your body, particularly your pancreas. Garlic fans, take heart. Research has revealed that garlic can help protect against alcohol-induced pancreatitis by neutralizing reactive oxygen species and lowering oxidative stress in the pancreas. So, the next time someone tells you that garlic breath stinks, tell them it's for your pancreas. There are numerous delectable ways to add garlic to your diet. Roast garlic cloves for a mellow, nutty flavor, or mince fresh garlic into sauces, soups, and stir fries to get the health benefits. Number 2. Blueberries. This is the most underappreciated fruit ever. These little blue fruits are rich in phytochemicals known as anthocyanins. The protective effects of anthocyanins against insulin resistance and type 2 diabetes are well established. Blueberries aid in the preservation of pancreatic cells, which produce the hormone insulin, which regulates blood sugar levels. These cells are in charge of insulin production. Obesity is a risk factor for type 2 diabetes because it increases beta cell destruction and insulin resistance. One animal study, however, discovered that blueberry supplementation may be an effective strategy to prevent obesity-induced insulin resistance by enhancing insulin resistance, by enhancing insulin sensitivity and protecting pancreatic cells. Blueberries were given to obese mice on a high-fat diet to test this notion. The mice displayed higher insulin sensitivity and glucose tolerance as compared to those that did not get the blueberry treatment. Furthermore, blueberries inhibited high-fat diet, induced cell growth, and increased cell survival. The study also discovered a possible role for blueberries in repairing pancreatic cells. According to the researchers, these discoveries could have significant ramifications for people with type 1 and type 2 diabetes. Fresh blueberries can be eaten as a snack, mixed with yogurt, or used as a topping for oatmeal or salads. Blueberries can also be frozen and used to make sauces, preserves, and baked products. When ingesting processed blueberries such as syrups or muffins, keep an eye out for added sugars. Number 3. Red grapes. Grapes, especially red ones, are tiny pancreatic heroes. They contain a lot of the antioxidant resveratrol, which is good for the pancreas. Resveratrol is an anti-inflammatory and antioxidant polyphenolic molecule discovered in plants. Inflammation can be harmful to the pancreas, so it's critical to eat foods that can help lower the risk of an inflamed pancreas. Flavonoids in red grapes have anti-inflammatory characteristics and reduce inflammation by blocking pro-inflammatory enzymes, decreasing excessive immunological activation, and lowering oxidative stress, anthocyanins, which give grapes their beautiful red color and have anti-inflammatory and antioxidant properties similar to resveratrol, are another component of grapes. According to one animal study, giving rats grape extract increased their pancreatic antioxidant levels, decreased the damage high blood sugar causes to pancreatic cells, and increased their insulin levels. This study may also aid in our understanding of the impact of grapes on our bodies. Grapes still contain some sugar, but eating a bunch at once won't harm your health. Instead, mix them with some protein or healthy fats, such as almonds or peanut butter. All of the benefits of grapes without the sugar rush. Number 4. Probiotics. Acute pancreatitis affects around 260,000 people in the United States each year. Pancreatitis is an inflammation of the pancreas that causes severe abdominal pain and nausea. To make matters worse, severe acute pancreatitis can be extremely dangerous, leading to severe complications such as infections in pancreatic tissue and even death. Scientists are striving to develop solutions to these problems. According to one explanation, the intestinal barrier in your gut is not doing its job properly, allowing hazardous bacteria to enter and trigger pancreatic infections. However, here is where probiotics come in. These living bacteria can be found in some foods and supplements and can enhance digestive health. Probiotics have been found in animal experiments to help strengthen the intestinal barrier and prevent dangerous bacteria from entering and infecting the pancreas. The good news doesn't end there. Probiotics have also shown potential benefits in human trials with severely ill patients. Antimicrobial peptides produced by probiotics fight off dangerous bacteria, while additional research is needed to completely understand the link between probiotics and severe acute pancreatitis. It's worth considering including some probiotics in your diet, such as Greek yogurt, sauerkraut, kefir, and other fermented foods. Number 5. Sweet potatoes. Sweet potatoes are another recommended vegetable for those who are experiencing pancreatic stress. They lower the risk of pancreatic cancer due to the abundance of micronutrients they contain. Improved pancreas function means sugars are absorbed more slowly into the body. Another benefit of eating sweet potatoes because they score low on the glycemic index. Antioxidants and anti-inflammatory substances are particularly abundant in sweet potatoes. Vitamin A is present, and it is present in fairly high concentrations. Vitamin A can improve better cell function in the pancreas, which may lead to increased insulin production. The vitamin A content of a single medium sweet potato is equivalent to 436% of the daily value. Furthermore, it contains 15% of the daily value for fiber, 15% of the daily value for potassium, and 36% of the value for vitamin C. Pancreatic health and function can be improved by including sweet potatoes in 3 to 5 weekly meals. The nicest aspect is that almost everybody likes the way they taste. They are a healthier and more naturally sweet option for use in recipes that call for sweetening. Other yellow and orange vegetables such as corn, squash, and carrots are available if you don't care for sweet potatoes. Number 6. Seeds. Although seeds are relatively small, they are surprisingly potent. Pancreatitis patients can greatly benefit from eating pumpkin and sunflower seeds. Sunflower seeds are rich in B vitamins, vitamin E, selenium, and magnesium, which may not be the first thing that comes to mind when you think of summer and baseball. They're an excellent source of fiber, protein, and healthy fats. Sunflower seeds, like nuts, are high in fat and should be eaten in moderation. I recommend limiting yourself to half a single serving and avoiding the salty, commercially packaged varieties. If sunflower seeds are a summer delight, pumpkin seeds bring to mind jack-o'-lanterns and the cool autumn air. Fortunately, most of us now have year-round access to pumpkin seeds, and believe it or not, they aren't just supposed to be scooped out and discarded. Pumpkin seeds are a delicious snack, especially when roasted. You may eat them alone or as a garnish on a salad or yogurt. Patients with pancreatitis can consider including pumpkin seeds in their diet because they are high in healthy fats, protein, and fiber. Number 7. Cruciferous Veggies. The risk of developing pancreatic cancer can be reduced by eating cruciferous vegetables like broccoli, cauliflower, Brussels sprouts, and cabbage. Yes, these unusual-looking vegetables contain sulfur compounds as well as health-promoting flavonoids such as apigenin and lutein. The antioxidant and anti-inflammatory qualities of cruciferous vegetables are among their most amazing elements. They can help protect your cells from free radical damage and keep inflammation at bay. According to one study on cruciferous vegetable consumption, people who consumed more cruciferous vegetables had a decreased risk of acquiring pancreatic cancer. So, the next time you're thinking about what to serve for supper, consider including these superfoods in your dishes. Number 8. Turmeric root. For Indian cooking, turmeric is like a superpower. It gives your food a gorgeous golden color and provides your body with numerous health benefits, particularly for your pancreas. So, what's the key to turmeric's potency? It's all thanks to curcumin, a bioactive molecule. Curcumin has anti-inflammatory characteristics that can protect your pancreas from damage and inflammation. Curcumin has also been shown in studies to successfully lower the incidence of diabetes in those with pre-diabetes. Pre-diabetes is defined as having blood sugar levels that are higher than normal, but not yet high enough to be diagnosed as diabetes. Curcumin may help reduce the progression of diabetes in people with pre-diabetes by reducing inflammation and enhancing insulin sensitivity. Curcumin may also help treat pancreatic cancer, according to research. In pancreatic cancer cells, curcumin suppresses cell development and promotes apoptosis, or programmed cell death. While additional research is needed to properly understand curcumin's potential advantages for the pancreas, the preliminary findings are encouraging. Turmeric can be used in marinades for chicken, fish, or tofu. You may also make a turmeric latte or golden milk with it. Number 9. Whole grains. Whole grains are the way to go because processed carbs, like white bread and spaghetti, are among the worst foods for pancreatitis. Fortunately, there are numerous excellent sources of whole grains. Brown rice, buckwheat, polenta, millet, teff, and amaranth are all grains. Some of these you've probably heard of, while others you haven't. We'll start with the most fundamental, brown rice. This cuisine is abundant in fiber and manganese, and it is the finest substitute for white rice. Like most foods, you should keep track of how much you eat because they are high in calories. Buckwheat is similar to rice in that it is high in protein and fiber while also being gluten-free. It's high in antioxidants and easy to digest, which is beneficial to the pancreas. Polenta, on the other hand, is a coarse grind that resembles corn. It's popular in the Mediterranean. We also have millet, which is similar to buckwheat in that it is high in fiber, naturally gluten-free, and easily digestible. Most people mistake it for a grain, however. According to sources, it's a seed. Next we have is teff, an Ethiopian grain that promotes weight loss, boosts the immune system, supports bone health, and aids digestion. You may create oatmeal, pancakes, and even tortillas with it. And finally, an ancient grain you've probably never heard of, amaranth, has a lot of fiber, manganese, and protein. This gluten-free whole grain helps with digestive health, inflammation reduction, and weight loss. All of the aforementioned are excellent choices for whole grains in a pancreatitis diet. Lastly, number 10, citrus fruits. It's time to thank these brilliant and juicy fruits for all the good they do for your pancreas. When life delivers you lemons, limes, oranges, grapefruits, and kiwis, you don't simply receive a sour pucker. you're getting a lot of antioxidants, including vitamin C, flavonoids, limonoids, and carotenoids. These molecules act as your pancreas' protectors, shielding it from damaging free radicals and potentially lowering your chance of pancreatic cancer. Citrus fruits are also high in fiber. Fiber is a carbohydrate that the body cannot digest but must pass through the digestive system. Fiber provides a number of health benefits, including the ability to regulate blood sugar levels and promote good digestion. Fiber, in the case of the pancreas, can help limit the absorption of sugars and other nutrients in the small intestine, lowering the pancreas's workload and allowing it to create insulin and digestive enzymes more efficiently. Citrus fruits also have a number of additional nutrients that are beneficial to pancreatic health. They are high in vitamin B6, which is required for protein and fat metabolism, and magnesium, which is involved in insulin synthesis. It's as simple as peeling an orange to incorporate citrus into your regular diet. Start your day with a glass of freshly squeezed grapefruit juice or slice up some sour tangerines for a noon snack. Are you feeling fancy? For dinner, make a citrus-infused salad dressing or marinate some chicken in lemon juice. The options are limitless. What foods do you consume to support your pancreas? Please let us know in the comments section below. And please support our channel by subscribing and liking this video. Feel free to check out our other health-related videos on our channel to become a healthier version of yourself. This is Doc Healthy, signing off.